everybody, and welcome to Free State High School in Lawrence, Kansas. Tonight, the 13th annual Rock Chalk Round Ball Classic, featuring some of the biggest names in KU basketball, some of the biggest names in KU sports history, a celebrity basketball game to raise money and support for local kids with cancer. Hi, everybody. Again, I'm Leon Liebel, along with Josh Klingler and Kadetra Pulliam. She'll be on the sideline for us as we bring you the broadcast of tonight's game and everything that goes along with this terrific event. This, of course, founded and under the direction of the voice of the Kansas Jayhawks, Brian Haney. We're going to be hearing a lot from him tonight, but right now we're going to hear from Josh Klingler, as this should be a lot of fun. And what an impressive list of former athletes coming back to Lawrence to give back to the community.
Yeah, it's an awesome cause, and Brian Haney puts in so much work on this event. And obviously, when you have a bunch of former Jayhawks that want to come back and be a part of this kind of year in and year out, it's great to have, you know, former teammates, guys who never played together, different generations as well, Kansas basketball, both on the men's and women's side, and then some football players thrown in as well. My early observance, Leon, is other than Cole Aldrich, I have not seen a lot of work in the paint.
No, a lot of guys shooting from way outside.
A lot of guys jacking up threes, so I think we're going to have a little run-and-gun basketball tonight. It should be fun.
And I think a lot of people want to watch Ron Kellogg, who's back again. 58 years old, Ron Kellogg, one of the great shooters in the history of Kansas basketball back in the mid-80s. And, of course, one of his former teammates, Greg Dreiling.
There's Ron.
He's one of the coaches. There's Ron Kellogg.
Ron was here early this morning getting up shots.
I'm apparently running.
I'm a little concerned he might shoot himself out of this thing because he was one of the first ones in the gym again tonight. But he's knocking down jumpers. It should be fun.
And we got Marcus Morris and Markeith Morris are also both here. They're going to be on opposite teams. Marcus playing for the blue team. Markeith, who is about to sign with Miami Heat, he's on the red team. We got five active NBA players here. The Morris twins, Ben McLemore scheduled to be here. Devontae Graham.
And Svi Mykhailiuk.
So, who is playing tonight. We just got word that Svi is going to actually play. We knew he's going to be part of a three-point shooting contest against his former teammate, Devontae Graham, at halftime.
He's lacing them up.
They went at it last year in a virtual three-point contest that Devontae won. I understand Svi wasn't all that happy about it and wants some revenge.
So. I can see that.
And there
I can
he
see
is.
That. The fire continues to burn in a lot of these guys. So this is going to be a lot of fun. It's good to see, you know, a bunch of the former players come back. They were on campus and able to get some shots up at Allen Fieldhouse and the practice facility and everything, you know, earlier today, and kind of get together and reminisce. And so it's a pretty cool event, obviously, for a great cause. And then it's good to see a bunch of these guys get back together and a lot of smiles here at the gym tonight.
There's Devontae Graham, who should be smiling because he just signed a new 4-year, $47 million deal now with the New Orleans Pelicans as he moves on from the Charlotte Hornets, where he was really a fan favorite down in Charlotte the last couple of years. And maybe a bit of a surprise as a top NBA scorer. All right, we're going to take a timeout from Free State High School, the Rock Chalk Round Ball Classic. We'll be back with the starting lineups and more right after this. And welcome back to Free State High School in Lawrence. Again, I'm Leon Lieb along with Josh Klingler and Kenitra Pulliams as we bring you tonight the Rock Chalk Round Ball Classic, the celebrity basketball game raising money and support for local kids with cancer. And let's go down to Kenitra Pulliam. She has a guest already for us.
Yeah, Leon, we have Daryl Stuckey, one of the assistant coaches for tonight's game, one of the blue coaches. What does this game mean to you to be affecting so many positive impact in kids' lives?
I played defense my whole life, and tonight I'm playing a defensive minded for children. But at the most beautiful thing about it is that we're able to do something that we love, which is sports. All of us didn't play basketball. Some of us had aspirations to play basketball a little longer. Some of us needed to stop and did stop. But the beautiful thing is we all come together to play a team sport that we all love. Because most of us out here, because we love team sports. And even when people don't have an opportunity to create a team around them all the time, we're willing to stand in for them to be the team that they need.
Daryl Stuckey, thank you for your time. We now go to the player introductions.
And guard, a member of the Oklahoma City Thunder from the Ukraine, number 10, Fee Mykhailiuk. At guard, a former member of the Brooklyn Nets from Hoboken, New Jersey, number 10, Tyshawn Taylor. At guard, a former member of the Cleveland Cavaliers from Shreveport, Louisiana, number 12, Billy Thomas. At guard, a five-time Big 12 champion from right here at this basketball court, Free State High School, number 12, Brady Morningstar. At guard from the 2012 Final Four team from Las Vegas, Nevada, number 15, Elijah Johnson. At guard from the 2012 Final Four team, at guard, a three-time Big 12 champion from Lansing, Kansas, number 21, Clay Young. At guard, the latest member of the Portland Trail Blazers from St. Louis, Missouri, number 23, Ben McLemore. And at guard, one of the greatest defenders of the Bill Self era from Kansas City, Missouri, number 24, Travis Rutherford. And at power forward from the 2008 Orange Bowl team from Lawrence, number 35, Brandon McAnderson. At guard from Olathe, Kansas, number 42, Natalie Knight Johnson. And at forward, a world champion who just signed with the Miami Heat from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, wearing his pro number of 88, Markieff Morris. The Crimson Squad, coached by 10-year NBA veteran Greg Dreiling. Greg is assisted by Norma Roberts, Brandon Snyder, and David Lawrence. And now, let's meet tonight's participants from the blue team. Now, folks, you got to help me out with this one because you're going to recognize it in just a second. At guard, a 2008 national champion from New York, Russell Robinson, number 3. At guard, another 2008 national champion from Chicago, Illinois, number 4, Sharon Collins. At guard, the latest member of the New Orleans Pelicans from Raleigh, North Carolina, number 4, Devontae Graham. Now at guard, an iconic Kansas quarterback from Austin, Texas, the gunslinger number 5, Todd Reese. At forward, a former Big 12 Player of the Year and Los Angeles Clipper wearing his pro number of 8, Marcus Morris. At guard, the winningest Jayhawk of all time from Burlington, Kansas, number 14, Tyrell Reed. At forward, one of the greatest women's scorers in the modern era from Houston, Texas, number 21, Carolyn Davis. At guard, a JUCO All-American turned international star from Chicago, Illinois, number 23, Mario Little. At forward, the man who once posted 16 points and 16 rebounds in the national title game from Lee Summit, Missouri, number 42, Jeff Graves. At guard, a member of the 1986 Final Four team with one of the sweetest strokes in KU history from Omaha, Nebraska, number 44, Ron Kellogg. At center, an All-American, national champion, an NBA lottery pick from Bloomington, Minnesota, number 45, Cole Aldrich. And at forward, an Orange Bowl champ and former Buffalo Bill, number 85, Derek Fine. The blue team is coached by Calvin Pony Thompson. And the Pony is assisted by Curtis Townsend, Daryl Stuckey, and Terry Nooner. And now, before we tip off tonight's game, let's introduce all of you to this year's beneficiaries. We've got a big three. We go ahead and head on off the court, guys. We're going to introduce our superstars here tonight. We've got a big three, as strong as any you've ever seen. You can read their full stories in your game program. But first tonight, please direct your attention to the screen for a short video.
I'm Brandy, and this is Briella, and we are from Topeka, Kansas. Briella is a sassy little girl. She loves anything that her big sister does, but especially coloring, painting, puzzles, and running. She loves to run, she loves to climb, just anything any other one-year-old would love to do. Hearing once that your child has cancer is scary enough, but then to hear it a second time, I mean, it's just devastating. The Rock Chalk Round Ball Classic will help tremendously with all kinds of things. We had to make a couple trips up to Mayo Clinic, which was very expensive. We've had some help from other organizations as well, but everybody can only do so much. Had to pay for hotels, and we were there for a while, gas, just everything adds up so quickly. So Briella did 12 weeks of chemotherapy, and then she had surgery in the middle of May, and now she only has about 9 more weeks of chemotherapy left. At that point, we are crossing our fingers and praying that we have clear scans, and she's once again chemo-free.
My name is Amanda, and this is Matthew, and currently we live in Liberty, Missouri. He's a really fun little boy. He is wild and crazy and active and will shoot you with a Nerf gun the first chance he gets. Matthew's missed his entire childhood. He hasn't got to go to public school. He hasn't got to play basketball or do any of the things that all the other kids his age do. This is where Matthew spends his time, and so this is where I spend my time. And our entire lives are focused around fighting cancer. One of the things Matthew wants to do is help other kids. So I have told him that we would take a portion of these funds to help him write his book, the Matthew Chronicles of Fighting Cancer. He has his own analogies for good guys and bad guys and his fighters, and he wants other kids to be able to understand it like he does. And the financial assistance that we're gonna get from Rock Chalk Round Ball this year is going to help me stay afloat and stay on our feet a little bit longer. It's going to help us with our car payment and our house payment and everything else that's still happening in the world around us when we live in a hospital. We are so, so very grateful and thankful, and it means so much to us. And I know that Matthew doesn't understand the financial burdens because I try to let him be a child, but it really is going to make him live a happier life too without his parents being stressed out.
From Williamsburg, Kansas.
As soon as her feet hit the ground in the morning, she's ready to go, even through all the treatments. She's always got a smile on her face.
When I grow up, I want to be a hairstylist because it's fun and I get to do people's hair.
She says she gets her strength and strongness from me, but in all reality, I get it from her.
Here lately, we've been kind of struggling to keep food at the house, and then at home, trying to keep our electric bill and rent paid has been a huge challenge. With this Round Ball Classic, what they're going to do for us is be able to get us back on solid ground and not have the huge financial burden and stress from everything.
Definitely a huge relief knowing that there's people out there that's willing to help support and help us. Thank you from the bottom of our heart. If we could give back one day, we plan to.
Rock Chalk
Jayhawk KU.
And that is why we are here tonight. The big three, Briella, Matthew, and Riley, as we get ready for this basketball game to raise money and support for those youngsters with cancer here in the community. As they are now being introduced here at Free State High School.
The five all-stars of the night at forward, standing in at 4 feet, 2 inches tall. An 8-year-old from Wichita who turns 9 years old tomorrow, Eli Vela. Eli is joined by his mother and father, Crystal and Orlando, and his little brother, Ezekiel. At small forward, standing in at 3 feet, 4 inches tall, a 5-year-old from Baldwin City, Easton Bays. Easton is joined by her mother, Shailene, her father, Craig. And now, let's take a look at the folks who are our stars for today. Right now, let's go ahead with our top three this year at forward. At center, joining us by way of FaceTime from Children's Mercy Hospital in Kansas City, standing in at 4 feet, 5 inches tall, an 8-year-old from Liberty, Matthew Martin. Matthew is on FaceTime with his mom, Amanda, and little sister, Mackenzie. At forward, standing in at 4 feet, 4 inches tall, an 8-year-old from Williamsburg, Kansas, Riley Howell. Go, Riley, go! Riley is joined by her mom and dad, Kristen and Matt, and her brothers and sister, Hunter, Sierra, and Kenzie. That's the Howell family. And finally at point guard, joining us by way of FaceTime from back home in Topeka, where her whole family is quarantining due to a COVID exposure, an 18-month-old from the capital city, Briella Hayes. Briella is being connected on FaceTime by our family liaison, Erica Souter of Baby J's Legacy of Hope. All right, thank you, gentlemen and ladies.
Those are the real stars of tonight. We are going to get ready for some basketball coming up right after this. And welcome back, everybody, to the Rock Chalk Roundball Classic, the 13th annual celebrity basketball game here. Former KU athletes and presented by Brian Haney, the voice of the Kansas Jayhawks. Again, I'm Leon Liebel along with Josh Klingler. Kenitra Williams on the sideline. She'll be providing us with a lot of interviews as we're getting ready for tip-off. And I got to tell you, Josh, the videos we just saw, the kids being introduced, really bringing it home, man, what it's all about.
And that's why the players come back for this as well. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's giving back to the community. It's hearing the stories of families who really could, use the help. And they come back. And, you know, Brian does a great job of kind of corralling everybody and getting them back here in Lawrence. But, you know, they love to come back and give back. So it's pretty cool to see so many willing to come back and be part of this event.
So many moving parts to put all this together, too. What a great job Brian Haney does to get it all together. And there's one of our stars of the night.
Yep.
That's Riley. She took off running right down the line there and getting high fives. And that was terrific. Hey, let's go down to Kenitra Williams. She has a special guest.
Yeah, we got Sharon Collins here. Okay, so you and Devontae both wearing number 4. Who takes bragging rights on that number?
We never talked about it like that, but I think if we had to, it had to be me, because maybe I'm the oldest. One a little bit more, maybe. But,
and maybe because you have a championship ring?
That'll do it. Yeah, but we never talk about it. Devontae Ford will be up in the Raptors, too. He deserves it. Nick is the OG, so hey.
What does it mean to be a part of a game that benefits so many families?
It's great. It's great that even more guys start coming back, especially the younger, popular guys. So that's good for the event. And I think we all, now being fathers, it means a lot to us. You know, that's the least we can do is support these kids and families that have been supporting us. So we just want to show the support and give it back.
All right, Sharon, thanks so much, guys. Back to you.
All right, Kenitra, thank you so much. Sharon Collins, one of the great Kansas Jayhawks of all time.
He's got a title. He's 4.
And he played a big role in that title as well.
He would be 4 in front of Devontae. No offense to Devontae. He's doing all right himself. But, yeah, he's the previous 4. It's pretty good lineage of jersey numbers, though.
And there's Devontae Graham again on the blue team with Russell Robinson, Sharon Collins, Todd Reese, Marcus Morris, Tyrell Reed, Mario Little, Jeff Graves, Ron Kellogg, Cole Aldrich, Derek Fine. A lot of shooters on that blue team.
Yeah, I'm looking at the blue team, and I think if Calvin Thompson's watching warm-ups, keep your eye on Tyrell Reed.
Oh, man, Tyrell Reed was on fire.
He's still firing away.
And you brought up the fact he'd be a great guy to sneak into a game at the Y, and maybe no one would notice who he is.
Yeah, and then, I mean, he didn't miss in warm-ups, so I'm keeping an eye on Tyrell Reed. And then
You know, Ben McLemore loves to put on a show at this event on the Red Squad, so keep an eye for the high-flying, still high-flying Ben McLemore, one of the NBA guys, obviously.
That's going to be Cole Aldrich jumping center for the blue team up against Markieff Morris, the newest member of the Miami Heat, again leaving the Lakers to go to the Heat. And I mentioned to you, he's too young for the Lakers anymore. So, oh, from outside, a three. All right, the blue team up 3-0. Is that Mario Little?
That's Mario Little for three, yeah.
And another three off balance from the right side corner.
As I was describing, there were not a lot of plays in the paint, not a lot of warming up in the paint. Cole Aldrich was about the only guy I saw in the lane. So I think we're going to have a lot of threes. Hot hand.
The defense doesn't look real tight. And from that left side corner, it's good. 6-0, the blue on top.
Mario Little
coming up big. And Markieff Morris, now we got a little alley-oop slam, and the fans love that here at Free State High School. By the way, Jayhawk fans, first time really to see some basketball in person for a while.
That's
since
true.
Last year, the pandemic wiped everybody out, and the newest member of the New Orleans Pelicans, Devontae Graham, a fan favorite, obviously, from outside. I don't know if I can keep up with all this. How about Markieff?
The evolution of the Morris twins at Kansas, I thought was an interesting one, because I thought that was that kind of time where Bill Self allowed his guys to kind of showcase themselves for the next level, and we saw both of the Morris twins, suddenly they're expanding their jump shot. Oh, Mario Little's on fire.
He ran down the court before that ball went in. He knew it was going in.
Elijah Johnson. Good grief.
Elijah.
I told you, not a lot in the paint, Leon.
No, you called it. Good scouting report.
Cole Aldrich better run down the floor. He's not getting there fast enough to get
there's
in the paint.
Tyrell Reed.
Up.
He's got that great shot, and it's just perfect. And he hasn't lost it at all. He's got the perfect form and everything. Now Tyshawn Taylor, Markieff Morris. Another three.
Markus Morris got to get a hand up there.
By the way, Marcus 0-for-1. Yeah.
Come on.
Now Devontae Graham, who's terrific at penetrating and driving, but he's going to pull up and hit another three over Elijah Johnson. Elijah with a big smile on his face. Now let's see if he's going to answer right back. Well, nobody's going to guard him. Why not?
That's a veteran move there. That's a smart play by Elijah Johnson. The paint's wide open. Get a hard time about that, but
what a great crowd. We couldn't fill it up tonight because of the pandemic situation, but man.
Well, see, that's why Cole Aldrich should have been in the paint. He missed the three for the blue squad.
Relaford off balance. This is just incredible.
Travis Relaford, among the guys, looks like he could still get out there and ball quite a bit.
By the way, if you're keeping or if you're interested in the format, it's 20-minute halves, a running clock, and then the slam, Tyshawn Taylor.
With a little talk to the blue bench as well on his way by after that.
Again, 20-minute halves. The clock will be running until the final 2 minutes. Oh, there's a bad miss. That was Relaford. And he's getting a little dig from his teammates and opponents there. Markus Morris. Now, he's 0-for-1, but he's a little too short again.
Can't hesitate there. Got your brother guarding you. You got to go right up.
Comes Markieff.
This is getting personal here. The Morris twins.
The crowd loves it. Steps back. Aldrich comes up with a rebound. Yeah, we even saw Todd Reesing in warm up from like half court. Yeah, another turnover. You know, Elijah Johnson and Cole Aldrich not challenging him. Reed from way outside. Oh, air ball. Oh, my. Well, we were just bragging about him. And Mark is going to throw one up from way outside. He's 0-for-3.
We should tell him we're playing high school three-point line. You don't have to shoot that NBA distance, but these guys haven't gotten the memo. Wholesale subs here.
I guess the clock will stop during the subs here. Who's all coming in now. We got Sharon Collins, Jeff Graves, Ryan Kellogg. I'm anxious to see him play. Todd Reese. And Kellogg, as we mentioned in the pregame, out here about 11 hours ago, running the court, running sprints, and shooting. 58 years old, Ron Kellogg. There he is. One of the great shooters in KU history. Not just a volume guy either. He was an incredible high percentage. The game against Nebraska, everybody talked about. 16 of 19 from the field and perfect from the free throw line that night.
Well, he's getting extra points in my book, Leon, because his college teammates, Greg Dreiling and Calvin Thompson, are both coaches. And he's out here playing tonight. Daniel McCray.
Hey, Daniel McCray, the first-round draft pick of the Connecticut Sun back in 2010. Seventh overall pick, highest draft pick in KU women's history. She gets the rebound, is going to push it up. Gets it down to, oh, the slam. Nice pass from Tyshawn Taylor. And Ben McLemore, the finish. McCray again. She led the charge the last time. And Tyshawn Taylor from the corner, the high arching three. Switch! I don't remember that high arching shot like that back when he played. Oh, here's Ron Kellogg. Oh, my. But Reese, Todd Reese with the follow, the quarterback.
That's gutsy by Reesing. I mean, he's down. He's down low, getting rebounds.
That's Ron Tate.
Oh, he ran back.
Collins,
he ran back door there too.
Yeah. That's Jeff Graves, big stroke.
Reesing could always pass, and that's a good. That's a good job by the QB there.
Yeah, he knows how to find the open man.
To Jeff Graves.
By the way, it's 27-23 now. Keeping track of the score. Crimson team on top of the blue. And here's how we got going in this game. It was a three-pointer from Mario Little. He hit three in a row. And went from the left side corner. As he was on fire early in this game. Marquise Morris and then the alley-oop slam to Ben McLemore. And then Devontae Graham with the three-pointer. Back to live action. How about Reezing the spin in the lane? And can't get it over Clay Young.
He wants the foul. He's not going to get it.
Speed from three.
Again, Reesing, quarterback. Pass the ball.
Here he's got the ball now. He's going to shoot the three. Todd Reesing.
See, quarterback. Pass the ball.
His teammates are telling him that. Jeff Graves. Graves. Oh, boy.
He hit his first one.
Yeah, he looked good the first time.
Yep.
Here's another long bomber from the days gone by. Billy Thomas. Off the back of the rim. Things kind of slowing down now. Hot shooters apparently out of the game. But there's Ron Collins. Shuts me up right there for three.
Callan Thompson, the blue team, really working this bench here. He's been pacing up and down.
Brandon McAnderson also now in the game. Former KU football player. It's a missed shot. Oh, save on the far sideline by Sharon Collins, but red team comes up with it. And Svee from way downtown. Just not there. About Todd Reesing, he's everywhere. All around the basketball.
He was here early getting some shots up as well. That's why I said he should pass.
Here's Ron Kellogg, that left-handed shot. He's got the shooter's touch.
Yeah, there it is.
Smile on Ron Kellogg's face. Omaha, Nebraska.
1,500 plus points in his Jayhawk career.
The freshman class with Calvin Thompson. They were all recruited by Ted Owens that year, and then Larry Brown took over, and those guys went on to the Final Four in 1986. Really, really good basketball team that year. A lot of people thought that maybe one of the best KU teams of all time. Lost to Duke in the semifinals. Oh, my. Danielle McCray taking Todd Reesing down the baseline.
She got him the last time down the floor.
She got a step on him. Carolyn Davis, and that ball picked off. And, well, no harm, no foul, I guess. Ron Collins bumping into Clay Young. And Billy Thomas. Oh, Billy.
Now his elbow hurts. Yeah. See how that works? He's got that shoot, got the tendonitis, that shooter's elbow going. After that one was well off the mark.
And Derek Fine comes into the basketball game. Former KU football player Derek Fine for the blue team. He'll be taking the ball out. In the backcourt, there's Devontae Graham also back in.
We We've got too many guys on the floor here for Blue, so we're deciding who's going to check out.
I'm not sure what's going on now. Is Sherrod Collins, is he going to walk off the floor the other way? But we've got the other three. Devontae Graham.
Yeah, Sherrod was the extra man, so he took himself out, avoiding the technical foul.
He just walked off the other end. Oh, Speed banks it in.
He even tried to say call that he and Devontae Graham now going one-on-one, which is great. Now when Thompson called timeout, he was, after that six man on the floor incident a moment ago, I felt like he needed to call timeout.
By the way, I talked to both head coaches before this game, Greg Dreiling and Calvin Thompson. I got the indication that Calvin was a little more serious about it. He had his starting five all planned out and everything, and Greg Dreiling was almost like, who do I got on this team? But all right, let's go down to Brian Haney.
Special presentation.
Thank you, Hank. And thank you, Round Ball family. How's everybody doing tonight? You having some fun? All right. We've got a fantastic evening planned. We're just getting started, but we want to call some special attention to some of the biggest donors each and every year for the Round Ball Classic, and that's McDonald's and the Dobsky family here in Lawrence. Did you know, in 13 years of the Rock Chalk Round Ball Classic, we've had 15 different McDonald's All-Americans play in this game. Three of them are with us here tonight. Greg Dreiling, come on down. Sherrod Collins, come on down. And Cole Aldrich, come on down. Where's Cole? Kevin Dobsky is with us tonight, presenting a check to our McDonald's All-Americans. Give it up for the Dobsky family and McDonald's for their generosity. All right, guys, let's get this game going.
All right, thank you, Brian Haney. Again, you know, Brian Haney, the voice of the Jayhawks.
You know how big this night is. The Hamburglar's here.
The Hamburglar, who I have not seen in a long time. Kenitra has another special guest for us. Let's go to Kenitra on the sidelines.
Joined by Ben McLemore. What is it about the Rock Chalk Round Ball Classic that you always bring a show?
The fans, the kids, the great cause. That's the biggest thing. And then always love to see these guys as well, these alumni guys. And just feel great to be back in Lawrence, too.
To be able to see your former teammates, how much do the stories grow over the years?
Always. There's always more stories, even when we was here in Kansas. And now, obviously, we separate ways and things like that. But we always keep in touch and just have different stories. But like I said, I love these guys. I love seeing these guys. I love coming back out here in Lawrence.
What does it mean to be forever a Jayhawk?
Blood, sweat, and tears. I'm always going to be a Jayhawk forever.
Ben, thank you for your time.
No problem. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Kenitra. We just found out Tyrell Reed's not just a shooter still. He can get up.
No,
he just had a
kidding.
Nice little reverse dunk. And Svee throwing it out to Billy Thomas in the right side corner.
You still don't want to mess with Cole Aldrich in the lane. He's going to knock that away. Good to see you, Ben McLemore, now signed a free agent deal with Portland after spending last year with the Lakers and then Houston, now a member of the Trailblazers.
And a guy that truly, truly loves coming back to Lawrence. He comes back every year for this game. And it's one of those guys that really enjoyed his college experience. And Svee, he banked one in, and now he just got, I'm not even sure what you call that one. That ball just spun in, and it counts.
That's a higher degree of difficulty.
Him and Devontae Graham are going to have a three-point shooting contest at halftime. That should be interesting to watch. There's Ben McLemore.
Ben McLemore, the highest scoring Jayhawk in this Round Ball Classic career. He's the career scoring leader in this event.
Oh, a long court pass down to Tyshawn Taylor, the quick outlet. Now Taylor's going to take the three from the left side corner. Derek Fine.
I need to get a close-up of Derek Fine. I was convinced it was Ted Lasso.
Well, that's what I was kind of thinking.
When we walked in the gym today, he has got a fantastic mustache going.
There's Derek
Fine. Former Jayhawk tight end and played a couple seasons in Buffalo. part of the Orange Bowl squad, of course, here at Kansas. I mean, that mustache looks great.
And Derek going to the bench. I don't know, somebody. I think Ben McLemore was just making fun of his.
I think if Derek gets stopped, especially over in Kansas City, they're going to think he's Jason Sudeikis.
I think we may be hearing from him shortly here. As
here's Natalie Knight.
Natalie Knight, who has a long legacy of KU, of her uncles who played. How about Cole Aldridge with a big jam? Let's go down to Kenitra Williams. She's got Derek Fine. Let's go down.
Yeah, we do have, I don't know if it's Jason Sudeikis, Ted Lasso, Derek Fine. What is the story behind the stash?
This is an original. This is an original Derek Fine. So 100% true story. I was at some friends probably a month ago, and we were watching Anchorman one night, just killing some time. So I'm on full in on mustache because I grow just like this incredibly thick, dirty mustache. And I told my wife about it, and she's like, yeah, I like that. Done, but right now.
Happy wife, happy life.
No.
So one of four members of the 08 Orange Bowl championship team to be back. What is that brotherhood about?
It's hard to explain. We were really, really close. Even back then, you know, we had a really, really tight team. And I think that you could see that on the field. And there's a lot of us that we've all stayed in touch. We still stay in touch now. Get excited about the good things and complain about all the bad things. But there's not really a definition put on it, but we just had a special group of guys that have all maintained our friendships and stayed together. And it was a special moment, and I'm really grateful for being a part of that and being a part of that group of guys, because really second to none.
And a lot of excitement about KU football.
Yes.
Lance Leipold, now the head coach for the Jayhawks, starting practice this week for fall camp. How excited are you about the start of a new season and a new era in Jayhawk football?
I'm really excited. I think that this is a good step in the right direction. I personally think, nothing against the other coaches or anything, I think this is the best hire they've made since Coach Mangino got fired, and so I'm really optimistic about that. You know, he's got a history of winning, and I don't care what level you're at, if you've won as much as he has, and that's a good thing, and that's what we need here to be able to build that. So I'm excited for the season, but I'm more so excited because of the changes that we got with a new head coach, a new AD, a young guy that's, you know, a KU guy. And I'm excited for the future and what's coming ahead. Yeah.
Derek, thank you for your time. Guys, back to the action on the court.
All right, Kenitra, thank you so much. Derek Fine talking about that mustache, inspired by watching Anchorman one night. And
I think he's a dead ringer, though, for Jason Sudeikis and Ted Lasso.
It's there. That's good stuff
just
right there.
Right on. I don't.
Yeah, he could be mistaken for Jason Sudeikis there.
Yeah.
That's good. Oh my! Tyshawn Taylor, the big tomahawk jam.
Still in playing shape as well. Of course, part of that great run in 2012. Kind of that surprise run to the Final Four. That was a really fun run because it was kind of a surprise to see that team get as far as they did.
Yeah, I got to cover that that run that year all the way through. And those guys were really a great group of guys to talk to. I remember Elijah Johnson was just a fun interview. You had to end the interview, though, because he just kept talking. And Elijah Johnson, his wife, Natalie Knight Johnson, they're playing together here. Yeah, so they have a basketball academy over in Kansas City. They have provided the ball boys for tonight's game as well. Those youngsters get a chance to hang out with some of their heroes.
Yeah, I'm excited to see Natalie get some more minutes. She has one of the smoother shots. She's a little selfless, though. She might dish the ball, but she can really shoot it as well. Part of the women's team, of course, at Kansas as well. The two of them now married. Here comes Ben McLemore. Look out.
Oh, showtime. Not quite there, though.
Went for it.
Ron Collins. Oh. Turnover. Let's see this one again. It's Ben McLemore trying to go off the backboard in the slam. Just a little too hot. By the way, the Crimson team stretching out the advantage here now, 55-41, with 4 minutes left to go in the first half. And again, the clock will stop. We'll stop having a running clock at the 2 minute mark. Is that Reese? Boy, he is not shy.
He never was.
You know, I remember the very, very first time he came into the game, ran in, we're like, who is this little guy? And he just lit it up. He just has a ton of confidence. And still does, apparently.
Oh, absolutely. Todd Reesing's all over. They might as well just have a page for him in the football archives. He's got all the passing records here at Kansas and a terrific career. And get to see him quite a bit. He's back an awful lot, so it's always good to see him and play a little hoops tonight. Mario Little has been on fire
in this game.
The blue stars in this game. He's been good.
Unofficially, I believe he has 4 3-pointers. Oh, nice move by Danielle McCray. Switching hands in the lane. Going up with the right hand. That's a nice play. Here comes Ron Kellogg pushing it up, sort of. And Kellogg from way outside. You know, Ron Kellogg's one of those guys you often hear, if he only had the three-point line back when he played, but he still scored a lot of points. I think he had 5 straight games one year when he scored over 30 points in 5 consecutive games. Here's that Danielle McCray basket. Takes the pass. A little change of pace dribble and then just splits the defenders. Nice move.
All Big 12er for the Jayhawks a couple times. Honorable mention All-American, almost 2,000 points, 1,934 points in her career. She was terrific.
Hey, we got another check presentation. Let's go down to Brian Haney at midcourt.
Fourth shot to win a car from Crown Toyota. Purchase your tickets in the concourse for your chance to be tonight's lucky shooter. And thanks again to Miles Snair of Crown for making this possible. Here's a reminder, tonight's silent auction runs until the 5 minute mark of the second half. So be sure to look at that silent auction table in the entryway. And now here's Bryant with another check presentation.
Thank you, Hank. All right, guys. Every single one of you, we consider a round ball donor. If you paid 10 bucks to be here tonight, we appreciate you so much. Every single one of you helps to make this event great each year. It truly does take a village. But, absolutely. But obviously some donors give till it hurts. And when it comes to Creative One, for the last 8 years, they have been our number one contributor. This year giving $15,000 to the Round Ball Classic. Now normally, Mario Chalmers, Bud Stallworth, some of my favorite 15s, they would come out to accept this check, but my number one favorite 15 of all time is Elijah Johnson. So Elijah, will you come out here, pose for a picture for $15,000 from Creative One. Creative One, thank you guys for all you do in making the Round Ball Classic special. Coming up at halftime, guys, if you watched the virtual three-point contest last year where Devontae took down Spee, Mr. Mekhi Luke is out for his revenge at the half. Stay tuned.
All right, get another nice check, more money raised again for Brian Haney and crew. Devontae Graham. We just heard Devontae Graham and Svee Mikhailuk going to be competing in a three-point contest against each other at halftime. They did a virtual one a year ago. Devontae was here at Free State Gymnasium, and Svee was in Detroit.
They see on the screen right there, rockchalkroundball.com, if you can donate. Any amount is fantastic. Goes to great causes. We're helping out specifically three beneficiaries tonight, the big three, but do great work here in the community and giving back and helping families of those battling cancer. So anything you can donate, head to rockchalkroundballclassic.com.
It is a terrific event, and I gotta say, it's a lot of fun too, watching these guys and now some of the players on the far side throwing miniature basketballs into the crowd. Ben McLemore over there. We mentioned Ben. There's Devontae. Hey, Kenitra Williams, I think, is with Elijah Johnson, or going to be. We'll We'll head down there shortly, and let's see what we'll hear from Elijah.
All right, here with Elijah Johnson now. Your teammates with your life mate, your wife Natalie, what's that like? What is the trash talking in the house?
We don't really trash talk. She's a better shooter. I'm the better point guard. And we try to combine, make that thing, you know, full circle. But not too much trash talk.
But it is about teamwork because you and your wife have a basketball camp in Kansas City. What was the impetus behind that?
Well, I think it's ideal to be able to do something with your wife. Most people can't do that, whether that be because you're a lawyer and husband's a police officer or whatever the case may be. For us both to have a love for basketball and to figure out a way to tie it together, it just made sense for us. So we decided to open up a gym, and we've just been training kids and trying to help them get to the goals that they have set for life.
What is the best piece of coaching advice that you got from Bill Self?
Don't lie to them. Tell them the truth. Tell them the truth. They can do something with it or they can ignore it. But you shouldn't false advertise people, so I try to hang my hat on that.
To be able to have a fingerprint on the ball boys here in tonight's game, what does that mean?
It feels great to see one of my boys over here smiling ear to ear, seeing all of these guys. They had no idea what they were coming to. So when they walked through the door and saw all of the guys, I know it was just a moment that they'll never forget, and it feels good to me to help them experience that.
That's Elijah Johnson making a difference along with his teammates in tonight's game.
Thank you.
All right, Kenita, thank you so much, and thank you, Elijah Johnson. And I got to say, Brian Henney called him his favorite 15 of all time, and as somebody who got to cover this team a lot back when I was in the media full time, Elijah Johnson was a terrific guy to talk to and still doing good work with the youngsters.
Well, it's funny, my years not only covering the men's team but calling the women's game. I feel old, but I say they are such an adorable couple, the two of them that met at Kansas, and he and Natalie Knight and their combined love for basketball now giving a little back as well.
It is a family affair, and again, Natalie Knight.
And he's right, she's a better shooter.
Natalie Knight, longtime KU fans know her legacy. Her uncle Danny Knight, one of the great KU players of all time, Final Four team back in 1974. Kelly Knight, another one of her uncles, a great player in the Ted Owens, Larry Brown era. And Mark Knight, her uncle, was a walk-on at KU from Salina, Kansas. The Knights as Sharon Collins.
And McLemore wants to try it again.
Yeah, this one's just going to be simple for him anyway.
No backboard that time. Just going to stuff it right home.
All right, Devontae Graham, is he? Oh, he's doing a little backboard work, and he doesn't quite make it. Now Svee. Oh! It's starting to become kind of a game of horse here now. A little 360 action there from Ben McLemore. Sort of a 360.
We got the threes earlier. We're getting the dunks in at the latter part of this opening half.
Again, 67-47, the red team on top. And finally, Marcus Morris hits a three. And Tyrell Reed's doing push-ups after that one. That's Marcus Morris's first basket, I believe. He was struggling early. And that is the end of the first half of play. Let's look at this again. Marcus Morris, on the blue team here. Little head fake, little ball fake in the three. Perfect.
Bad for the Clipper.
That cuts the lead 67-50. The Crimson on top at halftime here at Free State High School. We're going to be back with more right after this.
We got him. All right, come on down.
So we're going to have somebody shoot here at halftime.
Yeah,
for,
we're back here at halftime at the Round Ball Rock Chalk Classic. And Brian Haney, just by the way, got a well-deserved standing ovation here for all the work he does. And they have a drawing here, and fan will get to shoot for a car here at halftime. Let's go down to Brian Haney.
For the legal stuff. Did you ever play professional basketball?
Never.
Did you ever play D1 basketball?
Never.
Did you ever watch D1 basketball?
All night long.
All right, let's do it. Sign up Richard real fast. We'll get the cameras on. Who thinks Richard from Topeka can walk out of here with a brand new car? All right, can't cross the line. We're going this direction. You need to stretch out and get loose, or you good? Richard from Topeka, make some noise for Richard, everybody. That direction. Right here. Never up, never in. Make sure it gets there. For a brand new car from Crown Automotive. Oh! Good try, Richard. Good try. Big thanks to Miles Snare at Crown Automotive. Miles, thank you so much, buddy. Give it up for Miles Snare.
Richard from Topeka there, not a bad effort.
No, not bad.
I thought it was, from our vantage point, on first glance, I thought it was a little more online, but just off to the right.
There's Richard. Now he's got a sore shoulder.
Yeah, he does. Yeah. He saw a few of the players on the floor pull that trick when they missed a shot in the first half. He decided he's going to use that as well.
I thought it was let's go back down to Ryan.
So give it up for your Jayhawks who all made that possible. But as I mentioned, Devontae was the winner, and so like any great champion, he deserves his trophy. Dan Besko carves these trophies with a chainsaw. He's from Kansaw Carvings, and he has a special Devontae Graham trophy. Devontae, come get your prize, my man. It's actually got Devontae's name and number on the back. All this was done with a chainsaw. Isn't that amazing? Give it up for Dan Besko, everybody. Way to go, Devontae. Now, do you think you can defend this trophy? Because Svi's out for redemption here.
I'm hot today.
You have the option. Do you want to go first or second?
Oh, I'm going to go second.
Okay, Svi. Svi for three, you got to go first. Pick your corner. We got no time. Now, Svi, you had the best first round score last year, but he got you in the finals. What's it going to take to make it different this time around?
Just make a couple more shots, that's about it.
Couple more shots. Man, a few words, but a lot of big shots. All right. Give it up for Sviatoslav Mikhailiuk. Let's do this, everybody. One. Two. Three. Svi for three with three balls down. Four. Five. Six. He's heating up. Four out of five. Seven down for Mikhailiuk. Eight, nine, 10 down for Mikhailiuk, 11, 12, 13 down for Svi. All right, one more rack to go. 13 currently. Can he heat it up down the stretch? 14. 15. And one last ball. All right, 15. Give it up for Sviatoslav Mikhailiuk.
All right, there is Svi with, what was it, 15?
15, yep.
15 he made, and again, trying to defeat Devontae Graham. Graham won this last year. It was a virtual three-point shooting contest because of the COVID pandemic a year ago. As Devontae was here at Free State shooting his three-pointers as he won that competition, Svi was in Detroit. Again, a virtual competition. And I understand Svi was, I don't want to say mad, but he was
looking for revenge.
Yeah, the competitive juices are flowing, and he wanted some revenge.
They didn't get to be in the same gym, you know, talking trash or anything. So,
by the way, I noticed something about Spieth shooting. He was way back shooting the NBA three-pointer, as we do have the high school three-pointer here at Free State. Let's go back down
to Brian. But still modest. All right. 15 is the number to beat. Let's get some music going. Devontae, whenever you're ready. Boom. Two. Three. Wow. A perfect rack. Six. Will he miss? Eight. Nine. Wow. 10. Two racks to go. He's down three. 13. 14. He's tied him for the lead. He got it. 16 for Devontae. 17. 18. 18 threes. Once a champion, still a champion, Devontae Graham. Let's get a picture with the trophy, man. He defended his title. The $47 million man, Devontae Graham. Congratulations, buddy. Way to go. And Spieth Mykhailiuk, excellent job. Thank you so much for competing. All right, guys, let's get this second half underway.
So there you go. Devontae Graham winning that three-point contest against his old teammate Spieth, and 18 to 50. I didn't know think he was going to miss there for a while.
No, he was red hot out of the chute. He said he was hot, so I guess he was right. And I guess he can add a one to that trophy that he got at halftime just as a defending champion.
How about that trophy, a Jayhawk made from a chainsaw? It was impressive. Yeah, I think we're going to go down to Kenitra.
And Devontae.
And she's got the three-point shooting champion, Devontae Graham.
And we do have the defending three-point champion, Devontae Graham. How much did it help that last year you won it on this court?
It was good. I had a little, you know, home court advantage from doing it last year, so I felt good.
Tonight you start off making your first nine threes. How confident did you feel when you saw each one go in?
I felt great. You know, I've been working on my jump shot a lot this summer, so it's showing off.
How much have you talked to Spieth since last year's three-point competition in the Shooting for the Stars about that you are the champion?
Man, you know, I just talked about it a little bit, but, you know, that's my guy. I ain't going to brag too much on it.
A lot of changes for you professionally, leaving the Charlotte Hornets and now going to New Orleans. What is that opportunity for you?
Oh, it's a blessing. You know, New Orleans was really excited to get me, and I talked to them and the GM, and I'm excited. You know, it's a new chapter in my life, and I just can't wait to get to work.
But somewhat bittersweet leaving home?
Oh, definitely bittersweet leaving home, but sometimes you got to sacrifice some things.
Okay, we talked to Sharon earlier about who earns and the right to wear number four, you or him. And he says, since he has seniority, so maybe he gets it. And pretty soon, you know, your jersey will be hanging up in the rafters at Allen Fieldhouse. So in your opinion, who earns number four?
Oh, yeah, that's OG, man. OG got it, for sure, definitely. National championship, all of that. So he got it.
So Devontae respects his elders and gives props to Sharon. Guys, we send it back to you. Devontae, thank you.
All right, Kenitra, thank you so much. And Devontae Graham, what a week. Here he comes back and wins that three-point shooting contest. There's Saron Collins giving him the
like,
look.
Not so fast, youngster.
Yeah. I'm number four, the number four in KU history.
Two really good number fours. First-team All-American for Saron Collins. Consensus All-American as well for Devontae Graham. All the Big 12 honors, obviously. Saron Collins in the rafters, retired in February of 2018, and Devontae Graham will have an opportunity at that as well. Big 12 all defensive team for Devontae. He was fantastic. And where he came from to start as a freshman to the tail end of his career, man. He's now obviously taking that forward to the NBA. It's been pretty fun to watch.
Billy Thomas getting a three there. We're underway with second half action, and that's got the Crimson team up 68-52. But yeah, Devontae Graham, it's all paying off literally for him this week, signing that four-year, $47 million contract.
Little sign and trade with the as he ends up in
Pelicans.
New Orleans.
Yeah. He says it's kind of bittersweet leaving home. He's from Raleigh, North Carolina, but yeah, money's going to sweeten the pot a little bit, make it a little less bitter.
Well, I think the way he said it to you, they really want me.
Yeah.
And that's what you're looking for. Is money's nice, too. Don't get me wrong, but you want that team that wants to take advantage of your skill set.
Devontae missing that three. He's going to play a Zion Williamson down there, too. That'll
not
be
bad.
An interesting combination. As here come the Crimson team and Tyshawn Taylor. Out to Billy Thomas. Can he stay hot?
I think that we've got Marley. Is that our first foul?
I believe it is, because nobody's really been that close.
I wasn't keeping track. Mario Little whistled for the first foul here in the second half.
Well, nobody's been next to each other that close on defense to even come close to fouling. So
in a bunch of Spies jersey, I believe.
Tyrell Reed, he's been impressive from the outside. We saw him with a reverse dunk. Mario Little, who lit it up early for the blue team. Now he's going to shoot another three.
Cole Aldridge.
Boy, Cole Aldridge.
Thought about dunking that home or goaltending.
Aldridge just got their long arms, man. McLemore and now Svee. Oh, beautiful pass, Tyshawn Taylor. And I don't know, was that a pass from Svee?
That was an alley-oop for Billy Thomas, who wanted no part of that. He was comfortably in the corner.
He remained anchored on the floor.
That's right. Know who you're throwing the lob to, right?
Cole Aldridge going to bring it up. Little no-look pass. And maybe one too many passes from Cole.
He's right. He's blaming Marcus Morris for not running the break there.
But Tyshawn Taylor, he's moving really well in this game. We've seen him dunk a few times.
Tyshawn, of course,
Billy.
A couple seasons in Brooklyn.
Billy Thomas, another three.
That's why I said, don't throw me the lob. Give me the ball in the corner. I'll knock down the three.
Crimson up by 17 in this game, 71-54. Again, this is the round ball, Rock Chuck Round Ball Classic. Presented by the voice of the Jayhawks, Brian Haney. Raise money for youngsters with cancer, and just a terrific event. And a lot of fun, and the fans seem to be enjoying this tonight here at Free State High School.
McLemore's got to do a little extra running because he missed the three.
Long court pass down to Aldridge, and nice ball fake. Got Tyshawn Taylor off his feet, and then he slams it home.
Tyshawn thought better of going for the block shot on Cole.
Markeith Morris at the right side corner. In on his way to play for the Miami Heat. Oh, Tyrell Reed.
They just didn't throw enough lobs for Tyrell Reed in his Jayhawk
days. That's a second big dunk from Tyrell. Taylor and Mario Little on him, sort of. Now Billy Thomas. Oh, three three-pointers for Billy Thomas here in the second half.
Tyshawn Taylor always willing to distribute. He's just content navigating traffic and finding the open shooter.
Jeff Graves with the follow. The blue team. Their first basket of the second half. Oh, Ben McLemore could not finish. We've seen some spectacular misses from Ben tonight here on the dunks.
We might have goaltending there, I think, on Tyshawn Taylor.
That cuts the lead. By the way, Hank Booth, as the PA announcer tonight, has done a terrific job. And Hank, of course, a local Lawrence legend, longtime radio announcer and former PA announcer at Allen Fieldhouse, former PA announcer at Memorial Stadium as well. There's Hank, and just doing a terrific job tonight for us and for Brian Haney.
Is this our first action of the game for Brandon McAnderson? We seen BMAC on the floor.
He has been
time?
In the game. Okay. He has been. He was in the game the first
out there
half.
For the red team, the former Jayhawk fullback, now sideline reporter on the radio side for the Kansas football team.
Markeith Morris with that three-pointer as the Crimson back up by 17. Now Marcus is going to try to answer. He's just a little short all night. I believe he has 2 3-pointers. Now he's going to bomb one from way out there, and that's a brick. Mario Little has been on fire, and he continues to hit the three. He's got an interesting shot. He always falls to his left. It's kind of an off-balance shot. Elijah Johnson, you take that pass from his wife.
Yep.
And Natalie Knight threw it to him, and he missed it. She didn't get the assist. She needs to tell him about that on the way down.
He said she's the better shooter, so he should have dished it back. I don't know what this formation is. Look out.
Jeff Graves is plowing. Jeff Graves is like blocking. And Tyrell Reed, the three. And Mario. Oh, Tyrell Reed again. Blue trying to cut that lead. They do to 12 now, 77-65.
You know this one's going up, right?
I would assume it is. Markeith with his brother Marcus on him. And he backs up and shoots the three, and not there. And I think Kenitra Williams has another special guest. Let's go down to the sideline.
We have Billy Thomas, who left KU as the career three-point shooter at the time of your graduation. This record has since been broken. What did you think about the halftime three-point competition today?
It just brought back memories of when we did that last year and how if I make one more shot, then I'm in the final. That's all I could think about. But those young guys, I mean, great shooters. Our school has a tremendous history of guys that can shoot it. Ron Kellogg, you know, who's, you know, a little bit before me, a lot of guys. And so I just take pride in, you know, being included in that group.
A new beginning for you as the new head coach at Rockhurst High School. More than 200 career wins so far for you. Explain the opportunity before you at Rockhurst now.
You know, first I'd like to, you know, give a shout out to my old school, you know, giving me the opportunity to first start and some tremendous people, some tremendous things that were accomplished. Mm-hmm. And then on the Rockhurst, another tremendous opportunity. So grateful for it. The kids just, you know, needed a change of mentality, and I'm just so looking forward to it and where I'm at in my life now and everything that they present. I think it's a perfect match.
How did being a KU Jayhawk shape you as a man and as a coach?
As you see, you know, the people, you know, make the play. And so being able to come out for an event like this only speaks towards how special of a place it is. And this is just one of many examples. And so using the place, the people, the coaches and everybody that who influenced my life made it an easy transition into the real world.
That's Billy Thomas on the Crimson Squad. Guys, back to you.
All right, Kenitra, thank you so much. Great to hear from Billy Thomas. And continuing his basketball career as a head high school coach now at Rockhurst, and that's a terrific move for him. And now we see Ron Kellogg back in there for the blue team. And Derek Fine of a kind of a Euro step back there.
That was good. We just had Brandon McAnderson shoot a shot in the face of Todd Reesing. So the football boy is going toe-to-toe here.
Oh my, just over half court line, Markeith Morris showing some range. Steph Curry stuff there, man.
Todd Reesing, he's up there in the rebound numbers tonight.
Yeah, Reesing's one of those guys you played in the backyard in the driveway. Was like, God.
He just took
just
a three
away,
with Markeith Morris in his face. Todd.
Again, not afraid.
He's not.
He's just all over the place.
I don't think I'd look Calvin Thompson in the eye right now, though, because I'm not sure he's going to like that shot selection from Reesing. A timeout on the floor.
Calvin Thompson, again, the head coach of the blue team. His team is down 85-67. There's Todd Reesing. And I think we're going to hear from...
Yeah, we have a special presentation in the arena tonight, which is pretty cool that that Brian's going to tell you about here next. Here's the voice of the Jayhawks, Brian Haney.
Printing-solutions.com. And now please turn your attention to center court, where Brian Haney has a special recognition for the family of one of our former beneficiaries. Brian, take it away.
Thank you so much, Hank. Well, folks, we've been doing this for 13 years, and in that time, we've been able to get to know 42 amazing children, some of God's best to walk the earth we've met through the Round Ball Classic in the last 13 years. Unfortunately, as you can see on the wall to my left, we've lost 10 of them in that time. The latest of which happens to be, not that we're supposed to ever have favorites, but he's one of the kids that touched my soul as much as any, Nicholas Parscale. The number 19 represents the year in which he was a beneficiary. You may know him better as Nick the Brave. Who listened to Nick the Brave interview Bill Self on the Nick the Brave podcast? That's what this kid was all about. He fought cancer for 5 years, and yet you'd never see or hear him complain. He was all about the power of positivity, and he told his message of positivity through his podcast, the Nick the Brave podcast. And then he decided to write a book, which we're going to tell you about more in a second. But honest to God, this kid did more in his 14 years of life than most will do in 100 when it comes to impacting the lives of others, not worrying about what his next day was going to look like, just making the most of the day he was in. So at this time, as we honor one of my all-time favorite human beings, Nicholas Parscale, please welcome to center court Jerry Parscale, his mother, Dave Parscale, his father, and David, his brother, as well. If you would please direct your attention, we're going to watch a video in memory of Nick the Brave.
I like to play pool, like the billiard pool. I like Nerf guns, video games. I'm not a hard gamer, but I like to play video games.
Well, they call him Nicholas the Brave, all the nurses. And his statement when he got cancer, he turned to me one day and says, "You know why I have cancer?" I said, "Why, buddy?" He says, "So somebody else that can't handle it doesn't get it."
When I grow up, I want to be an oncologist, so I can tell them, I know what you're going through.
In the hospital, yeah, give it up for Nick. Lights on, please. When he was in the hospital, sure, he was concerned with his own fight, but he was also taking an interest in the other children. He was investing in the nurses and the doctors and the caretakers. That was just his soul. He had this infectious, contagious heart about him, unlike any I've ever seen. I mean, how many 14-year-olds do you know that have their own award-winning podcast, and then they author a book all for giving back and helping others so the next kid diagnosed with cancer doesn't have to head into it blind? That was Nick the Brave. That's Nicholas Parscale, number 19 on the wall over there. Give it up for the Parscale family, if you would. The courage they have to be here tonight. Nick's first dream, as you heard, was to grow up to be an oncologist, but his biggest dream was just to leave an impact, leave some kind of legacy to help others pay it forward. He believed into who much is given, much is expected, and he knew he was given the gift of interviewing, writing, all of these things, and that's why he had the podcast and the book, and that's why, even though he went home to be with the Lord 2 months ago, I believe he's here with us tonight, and his legacy will be paid forward and given to all of you, because that book that he wrote in the final year of his life is about to be given to 33 special kids in the audience by our 33 participants, autographed by each of them. Guys, go find a kid and do this for Nick the Brave. Any kid.
That's what Nick would have wanted. Find a kid to help pay it forward and build that legacy of one of the bravest young men anyone ever know. Give a hug to Devontae Grant, Jerry Parscale. Jerry Parscale. We love all of our heavenly 10 on the wall, but one more time, put your hands together for the family of Nicholas Parscale, Jerry Parscale, and Dave Parscale. God bless you, Nick. May you rest in peace, buddy. And before we resume, I'd just like to thank one of Nick's best friends, head coach Bill Self, because Coach Self bought those books and 100 more copies just like them because he believed in Nick's message too. So that, what you just witnessed there, was made possible by the best head coach in America, Bill Self. So give it up for him, everybody.
Yeah, what an inspirational story there of Nick Parscale. Nick the Brave, and certainly, wow, I don't even know what else to add to that. That was just an inspirational story all the way around. His parents there, and Bill Self buying all those books to hand out to all the kids tonight.
Yeah, Bill Self normally at this, likes to be at this event. He had to self-quarantine for a little bit, and so couldn't be here tonight, but helped purchase some books to hand out here in the crowd tonight, so.
Parscale here, seeing him on that video, what an attitude he had, and a positive attitude. Again, passed away at the age of 14 this past June, just 8 days shy of his 15th birthday.
Hey, head to rockchalkroundballclassic.com. Anything you can donate can help out families like Nick's, like our beneficiaries here tonight. Get involved. Any little bit can help. rockchalkroundballclassic.com to donate.
What a tremendous, tremendous event this is. Again, raising money, supporting these families and the kids, and having a little fun here playing some basketball with these former KU greats.
I really like Danielle McCray taking on Todd Reising, who I think got the knockaway that time. Those two have been going kind of toe-to-toe.
It's Ron Collins, the beneficiary. Here's Ted Lasso and Derek Fine in the lane.
I think Derek Fine was expecting Marquis Morris to get out of the way.
Oh, we got one of the ball boys coming out there to take on Elijah Johnson. Uh-oh, Reising. Yes, the three. Reising's that guy who just shows up at the playground. You're like, where'd he come from?
No filter. No filter. It's going up, Reising. Here's McCray taking it to the ball again.
Danielle McCray. There's Elijah Johnson trying to
Those are his
remember, those are the
his basketball academy kids that he brought here to be the ball boy tonight.
He brought him here to get dunked on.
Get in the lane and I'll dunk on you. So nice job avoiding trouble there.
That was our first free throw of the night as Daniel McCray misses that first shot. Natalie Knight with the interception of Todd Reising. How many people can say that? Ball goes out of bounds on the other end. Todd Reising throwing the long court pass, and Natalie Knight picks it off.
You were hoping for a late game situation, which would require Todd Reising to throw one of those.
Well, I was thinking if there's a Kristen Leitner type play, he certainly would be the candidate to throw the pass. Oh, a no-look pass from Derek Fine to his old quarterback, and Reising with the finish.
In reverse was Reising to Fine back in that Orange Bowl season, but it's Fine returning the honor here.
A little no-look action there. Oh, my, a turnaround deep in the corner. Marquise Morris over Sharon Collins. I think he might have even been fouled.
He was.
But it is a three-pointer for Marquise Morris. And Ron Kellogg still firing him up from the outside. Clay Young coming up with a rebound. Here come the Crimson. Keefe is feeling it. Cool. Uh-oh, there's Reising again. McMoore just knocked the ball out of Reising's hands.
He did from the bench. Yeah, I didn't realize he was an in.
Reising again with the follow. Not this time. Trey may have got a hand on that one. They're having quite a battle. But Sharon Collins, number four.
He's got that look of finally one got the drop there.
Don't let him
play
score.
Young. Oh, his teammates thought he was going to dunk. Wholesale substitutions, as they say. Here's the Markieff Morris three-pointer.
I think Sharon is leaning on him here. He's got the hand on the hip.
That's a the hand check.
Hand to the back now. A little hip check. Oh, see, that's an and one.
That's a great three-pointer though for Morris. As Devontae Graham's back into the game. Now Marcus Morris. Marcus, not there. Markieff definitely has the bragging rights in this game individually, but
all of the knockaway and the three for Marcus. So
wow, I got a little too soon there.
He heard you.
The Crimson team is winning this game, also 89-75, as you see there.
I might have saw a little full court press set up there. Marcus Morris was guarding the inbounder.
Tyshawn Taylor, the three.
Now, I think.
Yeah, just no, there's no shot clock here, is there?
No need for one.
High school gym here. Maybe we'll get those someday. But yeah, we definitely don't need a shot clock in this game. As Marcus Morris trying for two in a row, not there, and Svee comes up with a loose ball rebound and he'll bring it down that far sideline, a little off balance. Again, he lost to Devontae Graham in that 3-point shooting contest at halftime. And there's Mario Little. Is that a three?
That was a three. In transition.
Boy, Mario. And he always, again, kind of fades to his left when he shoots. Tyshawn with the high arching three again. Little. Head fake. And not this time. Travis Relaford all over him. Relaford, one of the great defenders in the Bill Self era.
Little wanted the foul there. The blue bench did as well.
Oh, yeah. We're going to have a basket interference there, a goaltending. Tyrell Reed's three will count.
Somebody Sean Taylor grabbed the net.
Really,
Tyrell
knocked.
Said, come on, let that thing fall.
Yeah, it did affect the shot. I think the basket was bouncing all over the place. Markieff Morris, Cole Aldrich on him. Yeah, good deed by Cole Aldrich. Comes up with a loose ball. And Graham with the steal. Donate from near DeSoto that time. Might be getting a little sloppy now, Josh.
It was intense for a moment. Now, we're back to run and gun, aren't we?
92-84, and Markieff, we get a little alley-oop. Not there. Macklemore comes up with the ball, though. The Red Crimson team will keep it. Here's Mario. Boy, Cole Aldrich is... Do you know goaltending's against the rules? He's always... Looked like he's going to grab the ball every time.
I think he's just getting the arms up there. In case it bounces off, he'll just kind of bat it in. But still operating around the net. Around the rim.
Cole Aldrich with a offensive rebounding exhibition right now. That's four offensive rebounds in a row from Cole Aldrich. That time, though, he steps on the baseline. He's out of bounds. And it'll be Crimson's ball. And Macklemore. Svee, I think he's going to shoot this, don't you? and it bounces over the backboard and out of bounds.
Devontae Graham ducked out of that one defensively and gave him the open look. Maybe it was too open.
There's Marcus Morris. Ball screen over there and now throws it off Cole Aldrich's hands and out of bounds. And the Crimson team's basketball. Oh, steal! Devontae Graham kind of snuck in there and gets the shot off the glass and in as Sharon Collins comes back in for the blue team. I think Cole Aldridge is coming out. Greg Dreiling had a few words here for Cole as he was walking out. Two big men sharing some things. Let's go back down to Ryan Haney for another check presentation.
A 50-50 raffle in just a second, so get those tickets ready. But first, a special shout out to our friends at Johnny's Tavern with Mr. Spencer Renfro. Come around. Thank you, guys. Spencer's coming down. Andrew Filer's coming down as well.
These guys have 11 area locations from Blue Springs to Topeka, but they've also got huge, huge hearts. They gave us $7,500 plus donated all the food to tomorrow night's first ever Round Bowl Classic at Royal Crest Lanes. So give it up for Johnny's Tavern of Lawrence, everybody. Thank you, guys. Nice guys. All right, let's get out those 50-50 raffle tickets, if we would, and if one of our assistants, Jenny, would come out here. Blue tickets, 50-50 raffle. First off, how much money was donated tonight for the 50-50?
$630.
Is that what's on the line, or that's the overall number? $315 on the line. Blue ticket, number 564-174. 174. Last three digits. 564-174. We got a winner. Go give that man his money. $315. Real quickly, before we get going, Calvin Thompson, come here for a second. Pony is such a good guy. He's been coaching in this game for 13 years, but he's also raising money for these kids for 13 years. You had every player sign that ball, didn't you?
Yes, I did. Everyone, even Kellogg.
Even Ron Kellogg, your old teammate from the 86 Final Four team. What do you think that ball's worth?
It's really priceless, but we can start at $500.
If we could get $500 from one person, this ball's going home with you. Keep in mind, this is for the kids. This is for Briella and Riley and Matthew. Is there one person with a big enough heart in the crowd tonight to give us $500 for that ball? Just stand up. Right here? Travis Peterson, you're going home with that ball. Give it up for Travis Peterson, everybody. All right, 3:27 to go. One final thank you. Last night, Jefferson's helped us raise $2,500 by donating 25% of all the wings you guys ate. So thanks for eating at Jefferson's, and big thanks to the Graham family for $2,500. Thank you, Jefferson.
All right, 3 minutes, 27 seconds left in this game, as Brian Haney just indicated, as the 94-83 lead.
I think we're going to steal Markieff Morris out of the game. He's actually on the floor, and Kenitra's got him down on the court.
You're right. Let's go down to Kenitra if we're ready. Yes.
No, we got Markieff Morris here, a quick interview. Free agency now, switching from the Western Conference down to Miami Heat. Talk about that opportunity.
It's where I belong. I'm back home.
There you go. 34% three-point shooter in your career. We see you pull up from just inside half court in the corner. Maybe next year you lobby Svi to represent the Crimson team in the three-point shootout?
Yeah, for sure. When I come back next year, I'm going to shoot about 40% in the league next year, though. Let me go ahead and finish this game.
There you go. Thank you.
Well, Markieff's pretty serious about finishing this.
Yeah, well, we kind of did grab him right in the middle. He was in the lineup. Thought we were helping out the blue team with a little comeback. Thought they'd just play the game without Markieff 5-on-4, and the blue team would have a shot at a little comeback here.
Here's Marcus Morris, and again, just hasn't been too consistent from the outside tonight. Not like his brother Markieff, who's been somewhat spectacular from the three-point line. Not just wide-open threes, either. He's got his brother Marcus on him. A little step back three. Yes.
Oh, again.
Oh, man.
Get on his wave off that steal, I think.
Get on his way to Miami to play for the Miami Heat, leaving the Los Angeles Lakers, where he's part of the NBA championship team last year. Tyrell Reed from three.
Probably the hardest championship to win, right? That was
the one in the bubble. Yeah.
Little alley from Tyshawn Taylor to himself there.
Not sure what that was, actually. It's Devontae Graham. And we got a whistle here? Yes.
I understand your surprise when you say that with your voice. Do we have a whistle here? Is that valid?
All I know is there was a substitution. Tyrell Reed's coming out for the blue team, and Ron Kellogg is back in.
He's wanting the ball.
Ron Kellogg down on the baseline. A little reverse underneath. He got it.
He asked for it. He got it.
And Mario Little with the assist.
Tyshawn Taylor helping to get Marcus Morris off Markieff.
Got a foul on Kellogg against Markieff Morris.
That's a good concession. It's a good foul. And smart, wise veteran foul.
And he is a veteran. 58 years old, Ron Kellogg. Going to be 59 in December. Travis Relaford to McLemore for three. And Ben McLemore, he says thank you. He kind of been struggling from the outside, and he got that one to go. Portland Trailblazer, again, one of five active NBA players in this round ball classic. Oh, he's got to shoot it. Ron Kellogg, a little too short. It's amazing, he's got that left-handed release, and he always had that little flip of the left hand that remains consistent to this day that he had way back in the 80s. We've hit the century mark here with the Crimson up 102-88. As we're nearing the 1 minute mark of this 13th annual Round Ball Classic. And I think that's going to be a goaltending on several levels. Hanging on the rim and then blocking the shot at the same time. Tyshawn Taylor. a half court bomb from Devontae Graham. Well, Marcus Morris.
Blue's still pressing. I mean, kinda.
You know, we mentioned things might be getting a little sloppy. I think they really are now, as we're down to the 42nd mark. And Tyshawn Taylor, who's had a lot of fun in this game. And again, with this high arching thing he's got going tonight. On the other end, Sharon Collins. Back to Collins from Mario Little. Misses again, but Mario again with the rebound. This time he's going to get it to Marcus. Marcus Morris for three. Maybe he's starting to heat up, but it's a little
hurry. Got to hurry.
Late.
Got to hurry. Blue needs a steal here.
Cut the lead to eight, though.
Can't even get a foul call in the backcourt. Mario Little was trying to.
McLemore. Whoa, he got another three. So we get down to the final 9 seconds of the game. Who will get the final shot here? Devontae Graham.
Who do you want taking the final shot for the Jayhawks? We always debated that, didn't we?
Yeah, Devontae Graham's not a bad candidate. And that shot is up and too hard from half court, but that's the end of the game as the Crimson goes on to win over the Blue 108-97 to bring to a conclusion the 13th annual Rock Chalk Round Ball Classic. And what a night. The fun and inspiration and so much more here at Free State High School.
Go to rockchalkroundballclassic.com. Anything you can contribute to help the cause. If you weren't able to get to the game tonight or take in some of the other events, you can always go to that website and contribute as well and benefit area families dealing with cancer. A lot of fun, though, tonight. A lot of shots up. As we mentioned, that three-point line turned out to be big. There wasn't a lot going on inside the arc. So. Gonna hand out our MVP.
Well, you know, we've had a lot of spectacular performances tonight, a lot of great outside shooting, and I think we got to go with the winning team and the player that perhaps was the most spectacular, Markieff Morris.
I think so.
The newest member of the Miami Heat, as he really put on a show, especially in the second half. Here's a three with his brother Marcus on him. This is the Mike's Got This Player of the Game, brought to you by DePasquale Moore Injury Attorneys. Visit DMLLawUSA.com for details. Mike DePasquale bringing us the Player of the Game, and there he is, Markieff Morris, coming back to Lawrence, the Morris twins, and kind of headlining along with Devontae Graham and so many more. And Josh, what a fun night it's been. And again, just a truly inspirational night. And kudos to Brian Haney for what he has done to put this together every year.
Yeah, 13 years of this event. It's been fantastic. It's bigger and bigger every single year and continues to benefit more and more people in the area. It's fantastic. Let's go down quickly to Brian Haney.
Travis Goff.
We'll pose for this side of the gym, and then we'll turn around for this side of the gym.
Okay, we're back. There's a chance for people to take pictures of all these great jams together.
Take a picture of your screen if you're not here. Take a picture of it right now.
That's a pretty good collection right there. Former Jayhawks, Travis Goff, who's named the honorary coach for both teams. The brand new athletic director at KU was just introduced as well. And she is out there. But Josh, what a fun night. Thanks for carrying me along here on this broadcast. We've had a lot of fun. And again, such a great cause helping these kids.
Yep,
and there they are.
And there was some of the past beneficiaries that are remembered here at the gym at Free State. And again, rockchalkroundballclassic.com to contribute. And anything you can contribute will help out some of the local kids battling cancer and their families.
All right, Josh, thank you so much. Again, for our producer, director, the incomparable Joe Novacek. My broadcast partners, Kenitra Williams, giving us all those terrific interviews tonight, Josh Klingler, and of course, again, the man who makes this all possible, the voice of the Jayhawks, Brian Haney. I'm Leon Liebel. We hope you have a great night, everybody, from Free State High School in Lawrence. Good night.